The school board meeting of Monday, June 27, 2016. I want to apologize for delay. We had some important matters that we had to go over in the back room. Sorry again. Let's get the meeting started. Please stand for Pledge of Allegiance. Roll call, Mrs. Dorn.
Mr. Casey.
Present.
Mr. Dwyer.
Present.
Mr. Duffy.
Present.
Mr. Rush.
Here.
Mr. McCandrick.
Present.
Mrs. Oleski.
Present.
Mr. Schuster.
Present.
Mr. Tinlin.
Present.
Mr. Sheridan.
Here.
Nine present.
Report from the PSBA representative, Director Dwight.
The PSBA recommendations as far as legislative priorities for the next year are in our on our agenda tonight. Proposing the idea that PSBA should in fact lobby for a greater funding, a fairer funding for urban districts, and also for a reconsideration of the busing formula for urban districts, and also consider supporting legislation as proposed by Senator Blake and Senator Hughes for modernization of older buildings in urban districts. That's all. Thank you.
Solicitor's report, Attorney John Minora.
Executive sessions were held on Wednesday, June 22nd, 2016, and this evening to discuss personnel litigation, negotiations, and real estate.
Thank you, Mr. Minora. Superintendent's report, Dr. Thierry.
My report this evening is based really around thanking our faculty, staff, administrators for a great school year and reminding everyone that registration for summer school has begun, and we will have summer school from June 27th to August 26th. That's it.
Thank you, Dr. Chairman, the public comment. First to speak is Taylor Judge.
Superintendent and school board members. My name is Waleska Tolan, and I am a graduate senior in Mrs. Roach's class at Monticello. We would just like to inform all of you of some achievements and events that our class has participated in the 2015-2016 school year, as well as offer our own special experiences.
Hello, my name is Taylor Judge. I'm a ninth grade student, also Ms. Roach's class. We attended a few interesting field trips this year. One trip was to Allied Services, where we learned about different colleges and jobs and agencies that help cater to students with different needs to help them succeed. Another was as part of our All For You program through the Old Forge Warhol. There we learned about the iron oxide that has polluted NEPA's rivers and streams. In return, we were donated some of the iron oxide to use in our pottery classes, where we made and sold pieces at last month's First Friday in downtown Scranton on May 6, 2016.
I would like to tell you a little bit about our senior class in 2016. 3 out of 8 students have been nominated and chosen as Students of the Month since September. I am proud to say that Taylor and I are two of these students. One student has been accepted into Marywood University and majoring in nursing. I am that student as well. We have a student accepted into Empire Beauty School for a career in cosmetology. 2 students hold part-time jobs in the community as well as maintaining their academics. Taylor was recently awarded Maverick of the Year and has presented with this award on Field Day. 6 students graduated this June from their home school, feeling prepared for life outside of school. Now we would like to tell you a little bit about our personal experiences at Monticello. When I first moved to Scranton, I was extremely shy and didn't really communicate with anyone. I stayed to myself. When I transferred to Monticello, it still took me some time to open up, but I did, and I am a lot happier now. The staff at Monticello helped me come out of my shell and showed me that I can graduate and become something. Before coming to Monticello, I did not think that I would have the opportunity. I am grateful for Monticello and hope others take the opportunities that Mr. Dennis Ingalls, Mrs. Roach, and other staff at Monticello have given me. If it wasn't for this school, I may not have made my goals come true. Thank you for giving your time to us and the opportunity to speak about the accomplishments at Monticello. Taylor would like to say a few words.
When people hear the name Monticello, they usually think of all the negative things that are associated with this school, when there is so much more good that happens inside the walls that people don't get to see, such as the great teachers and staff that gave me their chance. If they hadn't, I probably wouldn't be standing here. They truly helped me before I came to Monticello, I only attended 2 days out of my 8th grade school year. And since my first day at Monticello, I haven't missed one day. This school has helped me. This school has helped me in a way that challenges me with work without overwhelming me. I really enjoy everything about this school, and I can't wait until next school year starts to see what opportunities are in store for me. Thank you for letting me shed some light on all the good things that have been done for me and so many others. Thank you, and have a good night.
Poland?
That was okay, so we heard the one stone there. Okay, Christine Walker.
Good evening. My name is Christine Walker, and I'm a 5th grade teacher and our building rep at the Whittier Annex. First of all, I'm so happy to hear the success stories from Monticello. That's wonderful to hear. However, we still have some things on an elementary level that we really need to work on. Particularly our building, the annex this year, has had some very difficult problems with the emotional support students. First of all, we have students who were inappropriately placed into our building, despite the fact that we could not meet their needs. Also, we didn't have any therapeutic support for our students. We had students that needed far more than we were trained or qualified to give as educators. We are not therapists, we are not psychologists, and they needed more. In addition, in many cases, the SBBH team could not work with many of our students because of insurance restrictions or parents' refusal to participate in our program. We had special ed supervisors, primarily Michelle Rinaldi, who did not answer or respond to time-sensitive emails or attend meetings that had been called or had canceled at the last minute. And probably most disturbing is the fact that this year we had several autistic children that were placed into our emotional support classrooms. And really, the needs of these students were not seriously considered. But as a result, in our school, in our annex that has only 4th and 5th grade, we did have weapons, we did have drugs, we had violent behavior towards other students, teachers, and bus drivers. We had desks that were thrown in defiance. We had sexually inappropriate behaviors and language. We had profanities and expletives yelled at teachers. And we have had the Scranton Police Department at our school numerous times for students that could not be controlled in our elementary setting. I do understand the law, and I do understand that all children have the right to a quality education in a safe environment. However, considering this past year, the needs of approximately 10 students have superseded the needs and the rights of the 200 children who do attend the Whittier Annex every day. And these 200 children also are entitled to those same rights. parents have brought these serious concerns to our administrators and our superintendent, yet nothing has been done. However, just last week, we did have an incident at our fifth grade graduation where a grandparent of a student came as a personal guest of Sai Dwahi and displayed rude and ignorant behavior at this event. When my colleague Kim McIntyre and I brought this to the school board's attention, we were notified the very next day that the superintendent wanted to meet with us to discuss this incident. I am amazed and saddened that that particular incident would garner so much attention so quickly, when for the entire year, the safety and the educational needs of over 200 students have really been ignored. But thank you for your attention.
Christine, I remember meeting with you over at the annex.
And I thank you, Mr. Chair, and I thank Mr. Casey. You have listened to us with our concerns.
And I heard a lot of concerns that day, just what you read off. And I brought it back to the superintendent, and I told her, and I talked to the board about it, that, and we said that we need to have something done over there immediately, which we told the superintendent that she needed to talk to Mrs. Rinaldi to make sure that when she was called over there, that she went over there and addressed anything that any concerns of the teachers and the aides. And I hope that we're moving forward with that because it was a big concern. I heard a lot of complaints that day.
We did ask in one of the emails to have a meeting because we said as colleagues, as educators, as professionals, we can certainly work together to fix some of these or to make this better. And however, that was never granted. That was never addressed.
Kristen, you failed to mention that as soon as the word got to me, we immediately made adjustments in the student population that was causing the biggest concerns at your school.
We had some problems that were addressed that should not have been there to begin with. And we did have to fight. They were not supposed to be in this placement. So yes, adjustments were made. They should never have been there to begin with. And we still had children who should not have been there. So I had said to Mr. Sheridan, and I say this to all of the school board members, come to our building. Come meet our staff. Come meet the staff at the Whittier Annex. Come to the third floor and see what actually happens every day. You know, when we have these issues, you might hear about them, but we're dealing with them every single day. Come and ride bus 44 with me. I'm sure you'll enjoy the ride. And it's hard to put these problems in perspective if you don't see it every single day, and it seems it falls on deaf ears. So that's, yes, we did move some students, but there's still a lot more work to do.
And we realize there's more work to do. We tried to alleviate the situation to the best of our abilities at the time it took place.
Excuse me. What I'm concerned about is FERPA. You know, isolating a group of students, and I want to make certain that we don't violate those rights. I'm not certain that we have or haven't, but I'm
questioning. There are no names, and it is a problem. And you know, and I do want to add something else. And I again, as an educator, I understand FERP, I understand the law, but I guarantee you, if you pull any fourth or fifth grade student on a playground, and you ask them what's the problem in your school, they will identify every problem, everything that has happened. They have not been told, you know, anything that's confidential. This is what the children are witnessing. And the children are the ones who are going back and telling their family, oh, guess what so-and-so said to the teacher today? My teacher, Kim McIntyre, on a daily basis was cursed at by a student. 24 students could tell you exactly what happened. So yes, I will not mention names, but that this is something
just,
that has to
be
addressed.
That's all.
Absolutely.
I understand that.
But then also keep that in mind. As teachers, we try and keep everything quiet. We try and handle all of these situations. But we are being approached at the supermarket, at the baseball field, from parents saying, what is going on? My son or daughter came home and said this. So, you know, it is a real issue. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Thank you.
Scranton Federation of Teachers. Good evening.
Good Good evening, directors. Thank you so much for taking some time this evening to listen to some of the concerns at Whittier Annex. If you were to poll us tonight, you would say, I would have to say to you that you would hear those same issues from each of the 16 buildings in our district. It's pretty hard to move this microphone. It's very difficult to go in and do a job every day and have students using profanity and vulgarities that you just don't want me to repeat here tonight. But I think if I did, you'd start blushing. And our teachers hear that every single day, thrown in their face. And then they're also told they're going to be sued. So thank you very, very much for listening to what Chris just told you. Because as I said, if I turn around, I can call on teachers to get up here at one after the other from every one of our schools, and they'll tell you the exact same thing. We've got to pay attention. One of the issues that I would like to address this evening is something called a task force, special education task force. You have it in your packet this evening that you may or may not vote on a new model for special education. Because we're in education, we all of us here, all teachers in this room, all paraprofessionals in this room, and any teacher on this board, past or present, you know that this happens regularly. None of us get shocked by this. However, what I must address are a few concerns we have regarding a task force committee. According to our collective bargaining agreement, a committee is comprised of teachers and administrators equally. No one group has the say in that room. It's a committee that works together to try and solve or come to some good conclusion about whatever the issue happens to be. It could be math, it could be reading, it could be anything. In this case, it was special education. I was asked by Superintendent Kerrion to provide names. I did that. Now, not all of the names I supplied were on the committee. Some were not there. And I know that each member of the committee, including administrators, did not attend every meeting. However, it would seem imperative to me that on the night of a vote or the afternoon of a vote of a committee, that vote should be announced to the members of the committee. They should know what they're voting on so that all members get there and vote. On this particular committee, 12 people voted. Two of the 12 were secretaries who are not party to this. They're not in our collective bargaining. They're not members of the 1147. I don't vote, nor do any of my members, on any matter pertaining to the 1201 union. So that's how the unions get along well. We don't step on each other's turf. And I respect greatly every secretary and clerk in this district. I have terrific relationships with them. I've worked with them my whole life. I would never ask them to do my job, and they won't ask me to do theirs because I probably wouldn't be too good at it. So that's one issue that you should be aware of. 12 people out of approximately 30 participated in the vote, and you're going to vote on that. That equal representation is imperative. At the first meeting of a committee, we're supposed to elect a chair of the committee and a secretary of a committee. The secretary should send an agenda one week prior to a meeting so that everybody on that committee knows what it's about, and they go to the meeting, they participate, and votes are taken. That's how curriculum council works. That's how in-service council is supposed to work. That's how all of our committees are supposed to work. We're equals on that committee trying to come to a conclusion. That's all it's about. It's not a difficult proposition. And as I said, the vote should be taken, counted, and that's it, whatever that vote is. That recommendation then goes to the superintendent of schools. And that superintendent of schools then takes that recommendation to you, the board, to vote on. That's the procedure that we're supposed to follow in the Scranton School District. That's the procedure we've always followed in the Scranton School District. So, we have a committee, a task force committee. They've met a number of times. They were given literature to read and to talk. They were grouped, and then they came to a consensus. with this vote that was taken of the 12 people present. And that's what you're talking about tonight. We have had so many special education models and reading models and math models ad nauseum. That's nothing new. What you're about to discuss this evening is nothing new to anybody in this room. We deal with it all the time. That's fine. The collective bargaining agreement, I have said this in every single meeting that I was called to. My job as president of this union is to safeguard the every article in that contract, and I intend to do that. So whatever decision you make as a board, I just get to deal with it. Seniority is an issue in the collective bargaining agreement. There's a procedure to follow when you have a reduction in staff or transfers. It's clear how to do it. We've done it umpteen times in the Scranton School District. We've closed buildings, we've transferred staff, we've had reductions in staff over the years. We're familiar with the procedure. We all get it. Is it cumbersome? Yes. Is it going to take a lot of time for central personnel to get it done? I think so, yes. I think it will take time. Because district seniority lists have got to go into the buildings. Building seniority lists have to go into the buildings, as well as certifications. Because everybody has a right to bid on their based on their certification and their building seniority. And that we will follow. That's our job. Mine in particular. The other thing I would like to share with you is this. I get called to a lot of meetings, not just here in the Scranton School District, just meetings. I have to go to those meetings and I sit and I listen. Sometimes I'm able to say, okay, I get it. Other times I have to say, whoa, that's a heavy duty thing. You've got to give me some time. Let me deliberate on that. Last Thursday was no exception. I met, there's a very cordial meeting among Mr. Gaynard, Mrs. Cartagena, and myself. It was just a discussion, an informative session, and I asked Mr. Gaynard, and he said, yes, it affects the entire district. And I said, well, give me some time, I'll call you tomorrow, and I'll let you know what I think. And he said, well, you know, Fridays were closed. So I said, okay, I'll call you Monday, and I'll let you know. And as I promised him, I did call his office this morning, and I left a message for Mr. Gaynard. We will cooperate. I will do my job and follow that contract to a letter. You all know that. What you do in adjusting the schedules around here or voting on models of special education or anything else, that's your responsibility. Mine is to protect the collective bargaining agreement, and you better believe I'll do that. And sometimes you're going to say some things that maybe you don't want me to hear you say. And then other times you and I will agree. But that is my duty. And this time out, because this is affecting every area, elementary education, intermediate schools, and high schools are all affected. Everybody's certifications come into play, and we have to follow the book. And I'm going to see to it that that happens. So as I say, this is something that Mr. Gaynard gets to do. He gets his office in gear, and he has to put these things out to all the schools so everybody can do what they have to do in bid. And that's a huge issue, and I get it. We're already in July. There's no school office work on July 1, and there won't be anything on July the 4th, celebrating our country's liberty. And we all do that. The 5th of July starts everything. Time's running, the clock is ticking. So whatever decision this board makes tonight, so be it. But please don't call me to a meeting and sit down with me and say, we need you to make that decision right this second, because I'm not gonna do that. I don't make decisions like that. I had a predecessor that did that, and that's the reason I'm the president of the Scranton Federation of Teachers. Any kind of questions, several members of the task force are here. They're in this room someplace. I've seen them as I walked in, but it is what it is. We can't make it up. We can't change it. It is what it is. I do know the document that I just saw, the last document I saw, is, I think, the fourth revision of the document. So I don't know what you have in front of you tonight. I do know what I saw, the last one I saw. And so be it. And that's it. I hope that if there's a question, I hope I've addressed it for you plainly. Could there be a loss of jobs? Yes. Yes. Can I tell you how many? No. I can't. Nobody in this room tonight could tell you that. Not until the bidding process takes place. We won't know that number. I'm good at math, but I won't make up numbers. I don't believe in doing that. But yes, jobs can be lost. That happens all of the time with this kind of situation. Bids go out, people lose jobs. I don't like it. I know most of you don't like it. It's a fact. We'll know that after Mr. Gaynor sends out the bids. Thanks.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Point to the issue you'd like to respond to, Mrs. Bowman, and then you'll have the right to rebut.
I want to respond to Ms. Boland and to all of our special ed teachers who struggled this year. We're very much aware of what you've been going through. Rosemary and I have had numerous conversations and agreed that something different must be done, thus the task force. We call that a cross-functional action team. We tried to get as many different voices as possible on that team. The team really doesn't rely on a vote. It relies on a consensus. You study data. You assess the current situation of the school district. You design a desired status and try to build a program around that. And I compliment the team for doing that. The new program that the board has before them tonight has been discussed in detail. And what we believe the program will do to help all of us educate those students that we must educate is that it will add layers of support to the local schools, which you do not have right now. It will also ensure that those schools who do not have behavior teams will have behavior teams available to them. Every special education teacher will have a job. We shared with the board just the other evening all of the way the jobs would fall. We had 128 equals 128. We do not plan on anyone losing their job. We need you. How will you all be assigned? Mr. Gaynard and I had an extensive meeting today, and the moves will be made according to the contract. Will teachers be certified to teach in their new assignments if they have a new assignment? Yes. Teachers will be certified to teach the classes to which they are assigned. Will teachers be moved into new buildings? Yes, some teachers will change locations. This is all special ed I'm talking about. Will teachers' pay change based on the new appointments? Teachers will be paid according to the SFT contract. How soon will teachers know their assignments? As soon as possible. We are poised and ready upon a board's vote to move accordingly. And so I want to reassure you that we have heard you. We agree changes need to be made. And we have pulled you together along with our administrators to try to put a program in place that would be different than what you're used to right now, and to provide as many supports as possible to you in the local school. So in this case, Ms. Boland and I agree totally. You should be supported in the work you do, and we do need to make changes to the current special ed model we have. Thank you.
And Doctor, I'd like to add with that over the last few months, as board president, I sat down with many meetings with concerns with my board over job losses. And the first thing I said to the doctor, and I think she can verify this, is that I want a commitment from you right off the bat that this is not going to call for one job in the Scranton School District. And she confirmed that with me. And again, and the board has asked her, as of last week, we talked to her about that. And we are all confirmed that not one person will go home without a pink slip or without a paycheck through this special ed program. I just like to say that and make sure that's out there.
And Rosemary, I will say to you, I understand this is hard work ahead of us, and we're poised and ready to do so.
Mrs. Ball, you have...
Go to the mic.
The voices behind me are saying, what about the children? My understanding is, and somebody should correct me if I got this wrong, you're moving them back to their home schools or you're regionalizing the district. And some schools will have autistic support, learning support, life skills, and ED classes, emotional disabilities. Other schools won't because there's no room. So some schools will have perhaps one of the regions, my understanding is, includes Prescott Elementary, Adams Elementary, and Bancroft Elementary. So one of those buildings, I believe Prescott School, will have an autism class, Bancroft will have a life skills class, and Adams School will have an autistic class. They will be losing learning support teachers. This school alone will lose 3 learning support teachers, this building. Trip will lose 4. I don't have the rest of the paperwork with me to bring. Each building is being shifted, so the kids will be shifted. That, we all know that. That's a given with this new model. As far as supports, I learned about Utopia when I was a kid in school. That's a great idea. It's a terrific idea. It was a good story. And if you want to read a better one, read the book about Shangri-La. And just like Roosevelt said when we were attacked by Germany, when they said, where did our planes come from? He said Shangri-La. So I believe in all that. It's great. It's wonderful. It's a great idea. I'm an elementary teacher. I've been told a whole lot of stuff in my career. A lot of it happened. It was wonderful. And a lot of it didn't happen. And thanks to my colleagues, I survived all that. And that's what this group will do behind me and in all of your buildings. They'll survive because they know without each other, there's no success. They won't have a good year. Do I buy into a lot of it? I do not. And I just said to Mrs. Cartagena the other day, if you're planning on putting 6 people out there and calling them coaches, and they're going to go into our classrooms and they've never taught, they have very little experience, and they're going to tell a teacher with 15 years of experience how to do the job, you're going to flunk. It's going to fail before it gets out.
The coaches have to have at least 8 years special ed teaching experience.
Because that's what I
asked. So that's not what we're putting out there.
Well, it has to be said, because the other part of this equation, Alexis, is this. We can't have 6 people walking around like prima donnas thinking they're walking around like prima donnas while the rest of this group gets to work. That's not happening.
That the people we have on staff in our special ed department are professionals. I doubt very much that they're going to walk around like prima donnas, and hopefully they will be walking around trying to support their peers. That's what learning communities, collaboration, teachers working together, peer coaching is all about. And I don't have to preach it to you, you guys.
We have
to do something different. We would very much, we believe in this. We have a wonderful leader leading it. And I really believe it is
right.
something that will benefit the district, and we can't bury it before we even try it.
Well, I'm not trying to bury it. What I'm saying to you is before we walk away from this tonight, know this. This is not just about special education. The teachers have elementary certification in elementary schools. That's on the top of their certificate. When the bid goes out, they have building seniority based upon that certificate. So they're going to bid. Maybe they're not going to bid a special ed job. Maybe they're going to say, no, I've got the seniority in my school. I'm staying. The person with least seniority is out. That's a regular ed job. This is trickle-down economics.
Right.
This is how it works. I mean, you've been around. All of you know how this works. It's easy. But it takes umpteen hours of work to sort it out. And that's going to fall on Mr. Gaynor. That certificate says, well, not my team.
The administrative team.
But the team can't do that. The team can't do the seniority list. He has to do all that. We're not going to listen to teamwork on that.
Rosemary, we will do our job just as you're doing your job.
What they're telling you is they're going to bid based on their certification. Somehow we're getting twisted here that everybody thinks this is only about special ed cert. It isn't. It most certainly is not. It's about your certification. You have an elementary cert, you have a secondary cert, people have intermediate school certs, middle school certs. That's how they're going to bid. And if they've already put in 15 years in learning support, they're going to take this opportunity to say, I'm using my certification and I'm staying. This is what you have to understand. That's it.
Excuse me, Rudolph Brownson, Gertrude Hoffman. Is that what it is? Is it Gerard?
Oh, Gerard. Gerard.
You can see the sheet in it. I can't understand that one.
I know all the teachers can attest bad handwriting never goes away. So, not a problem. Good evening, folks. As always, Gerard Hetman from the Lackawanna County Commissioner's Office. Just a few items of note as we head into the summer months. I know we're all looking for ways to keep students, and also for that matter, parents, guardians, and faculty and staff engaged in doing healthy things. So on that note, we're proud to announce that this year, for the first time, swimming facilities at all four of our county parks are open. That includes the pool at McDade Park, the beaches at Roy Sarnaski and Aylesworth Park, and also new this year, the beach at Covington Park. These amenities are free and open to the public. Of course, we ask that people obey basic rules of decorum and park rules as they are posted, but they're free and open to the public. They run Monday through Sunday, 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. They're open through mid-August normally, give or take. So please come out and enjoy some free swimming at the county parks this year. There's a few other items that we have. Our annual Art in the Park series is back this year during the month of July on Tuesdays. Each of the four county parks hosts a different Art in the Park afternoon each Tuesday. We'll leave the schedule for that. And also the schedule for our remaining three family fun days. I kind of bill those as open houses at the county parks. They're a day to come out and enjoy some free food, entertainment, refreshments, music, games, in addition to all the other normal park amenities. We had our first one at McDade Park last Saturday, and we have one coming up at each of the three county parks over the course of the summer. And also, I'll leave a sample, and I've got some extras on me in case anyone wants one, of our new flyer on our prescription drug take-back boxes. About 3 years ago, in conjunction with the District Attorney's Office and our Office of Drug and Alcohol Programs, we put out a version of this flyer that detailed the three drop-off sites for prescription drugs in Lackawanna County where this can be safely disposed of. We've now added a fourth box up in Moscow, And we've updated the flyer just with some new information that's come out over the last few years. We've had requests from this from local governments, neighborhood groups, and other individuals, and we just wanted to bring out an updated version for your knowledge and information. Again, we know that prescription drug abuse is a major issue, not just in our community, but across our country and around the world, and the more unused, unneeded drugs we can safely dispose of, the more we can combat this epidemic and related illnesses and criminal acts. So, we've all that information. Are there any questions from the members tonight?
Great. That flyer with the board secretary, Joy?
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
And I've got some extras, too, in case anyone here or in the crowd wants one. Thank you, folks, and we'll see you next time. Have a great night.
Elaine Guerin?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Ooh. Elaine? Guerin? Guerin?
Young.
Is it?
Young.
Young. Look at that paper.
Elaine Young, and I am a crossing guard for St. Clair School. And every year, Mr. Sheridan, you send a letter asking if we're going to come back. And every year I say, I'm going to come back. But what about a raise? We have not had a raise in over a decade. Everybody else gets their raise. We never see a raise. So that's the short of the story. I'm not going to take too long. And also, I have 4 stop signs. For 3 years, I wanted crosswalks. Never got them. Finally, this year, they paved. I have 1 set of crosswalks, and I asked for 4. So maybe you can help me with that, too. Whose responsibility is it for a raise for the crossing guards?
Well, unfortunately, if you noticed, about 4 years ago, I fought for a raise for the crossing guards. And we had both parties, the boards, we had a party for you guys this year, and we gave awards and plaques out to every crossing guard.
Thank you very much, but I have to tell you, that plaque isn't going to go anywhere with my children.
We don't pay the crossing guards.
That's what I'm saying.
We don't pay the crossing guards. The city.
Well, yes, I am half paid by the school district, and I am half paid by the city of Scranton.
When I fought the war 4 years ago, unfortunately, it wasn't on our table. It was on the city of Scranton. Because the pay comes out of the city of Scranton. We only give 50% contribution towards it.
Yeah. Well, then talk to the council. I went to council about this, too, and they told me to come here. They said they had nothing. So I get paychecks from you, and I get paychecks from the city of Scranton. And I think it's time that the crossing guards, there's 70-some crossing guards. There are no substitutes. I was out 1 week this year. 2 policemen showed up. I was told the policemen would come every day. 2 showed up one day and said to the parents, what do we do? Now, the first set that I crossed, there's 30-some children, the teachers come with them. But then I have a bus 63 that comes back, and it has 3rd graders, 4th graders, 5th graders, but the 3rd and 4th graders are picking up a preschool child, and they're picking up a kindergarten child, and they're walking home, and there's nobody there to cross them all those 4 of those days that I was not there. So my concern is I think we're entitled to a raise, and I hope that you can get in touch with city council or whatever and get the raise for the crossing guards.
So listen, I agree 100%, and each and every one of us on this board has gone by your corners throughout the whole city and seen you out in all kinds of weather and crossing our kids and keeping them safe. And for me, I'm 1,000% behind a raise for every one of the crossing guards. I think you do a substantial job out there. I think you're out there, you're in the lane of traffic, and God knows, with everybody texting today, your lights are on the line every day. I see that, this board recognizes that, and I'm sure there's nobody on this board that would not step up and say to the city, let's give them a raise. I would.
Well, then I hope you'll do that. I've been on for 25 years.
Excuse me. President Sheridan, why don't we revisit?
Yes.
So, Sir Minor, explore it and revisit it.
We're going to revisit it, ma'am. And we're going to look right into that, see what we can do.
Solicitor Minor, this week, can you meet with Solicitor Schrader about potentially, I mean, it's difficult because they don't have any representation through unions, but could you come to a common ground, just a conversation to kick the wheels to start it this week, and come back to the board just with any report if anything was moved along?
Certainly.
Thank you.
Okay, and when they do the crosswalks, if you get that, I need a stop line. They should be stopping at that line.
I agree.
Okay?
Please meet.
Thank you.
Public comment. Is there anybody else who'd like to speak that is not on the list? Seeing nobody, okay, we'll move on. We have somebody?
My name is Frances Riggin. I'm a teacher in the Scranton School District. I have both elementary and special education degrees. I was a member of the task force, and I attended every single meeting. I just want to bring it to the attention, and I'm also a member of the executive board of the union, okay? And I was there because I had both elementary and special. We did discuss a lot of things, and it did come down to a vote. Some of the things in that draft that we voted on were never discussed in my group. I did voice my opinion on numerous times. You can ask anybody that was there. My concern is for the children. You know, I'm also a teacher, but the concern for the special ed children, just to randomly say, we're gonna put kids back to their home school that are autistic support and are thriving in other buildings. Now, I don't know about this regional team, because in every meeting I was at, it was never discussed. So I'm not sure what's going on and what the draft is or the recommendations that are on there. But they were certainly not discussed with me, a member of the task force. I did hear about the regional teams being set up and heard that we are getting life skills at Bancroft, but I don't know where those children are coming from. Your decision not only will affect the special ed teachers, but you're going to affect the special students. And that was my number one reason for getting on there. And was given and shown a paper that was supposed to be passed to every special ed parent of all the children that would be affected to go home and ask that parent, do you want your child moved back to their home school? That would be their right to go back to their home school with the law of special ed. I thought we should put that in the parent's hands. The parent of that child deserves the choice to say, yes, I want my child put back there. I don't believe even the task force had the right to say, we're moving your child back there. I was shown a paper and told it was going to go home to the autistic support students. I don't know about the other disabilities, was never shown that paper, to see if the parent was going to agree to send their child back to the home school. That would be within their right. I could just, that was perfectly fine if that's what they wanted. But we never got the results of those letters. I don't know if they were sent out. I don't know if we're just going to send a letter and say, your child is going to be moved out of a class where they might be thriving. And I know I was in on the task force, another principal said how wonderful their autistic support classes were and how those kids were achieving. I don't know, and I was on the task force, whether that class is staying intact or whether those children are being moved because we can put them back in the home school. I do know when you talk about supports, that is going to cost a tremendous amount of money to put all the supports needed in the plan that I was shown. I was told by the director of special ed that if those supports were not included in the passing of the task force, she would pull the plug. And that helped me a little bit to say that I know that they would be getting the supports if this went, but I haven't heard that tonight. And I know all the time in being a member of the executive board, there is no money. It is not only going to hopefully no one lose their job, you're going to have to add jobs to make this plan work efficiently and provide the support. So please, when you vote on this, take into consideration, number one, the special education students of the Scranton School District. Number two should come the staff. They give up. I was a special ed teacher for 18 years, and believe me, all of those people behind me give their soul every day, the compassion, The dedication that it takes to be a special education teacher is unbelievable. And I give them their credit, especially now in what we're asking them to do. And yes, changes need to be made, but there are some changes that can be made that don't cost any money and that can still improve the quality of special education in the Scranton School District.
Speaker.
Could someone just give us a short, we don't understand the plan, what this plan even is that's being voted on. I keep hearing about people moving out of schools, back to home schools and whatnot. We don't understand. We weren't on the task force, there's nobody teaching from our building that we're on it. We don't know. Could someone just give us a little bit of a covering?
Doctor says that she'll have a special meeting
tomorrow. Excuse me, this isn't the first meeting that this has been discussed. Mrs. Cartagena has answered questions at the meeting at West Scranton High School, at the special ed committee meeting in the boardroom. I mean, this isn't the first time this program has been questioned. It's not. I mean, we've done this, and we should do it again. But it's not like we're just dropping this out of the blue. We've been over this for 3 months.
Blake.
And again, Mrs. Cartagena has done that. I'm not the special ed director. I'm not the special ed director.
You're voting on it.
My name is Mary Delmar. I'm currently a reading special ed at Prescott Elementary School. Great school. Love the school. I did not prepare anything, but I have been seeing this. I was formerly a special education teacher for at least 12 years. I got a chance to look at some of this plan, a draft. I was not on the task force. I am a member of the executive board of the union. I just have so many questions, like, do the board members, do you know what you are voting on here? Like, do you clearly understand the logistics, Mr. Kowalski?
No, you don't.
I'm at Prescott School. We have not a single area of space left in the building, except for a computer lab that's somewhat run down and not functional. It would be great for the kids to be able to actually use that computer lab. That's the only room that I can even imagine that they're going to put a classroom. You want to put the kids back in their home schools, and I think a lot of the things in that plan I read, they were great, they made sense. Reading programs, remedial reading programs in the middle schools and the high schools, things that we absolutely should look at and invest in. But logistically, I do not see how this plan is going to work. I saw, in addition to just where are the classrooms going to go? At Prescott, you would, to do this correctly, you would need to have an autistic support class, at least one for K to 2, and then one for 3, 4, 5. You would need to have emotional support classroom or teams. Again, K to 2, 3, 4, 5. You would need to have so many different areas covered. I just don't know how each building is going to handle this. Regional teams is something I didn't even hear of until tonight. I mean, is this a whole new plan? Like,
It's not a whole new plan. It's tweaks to the plan to accommodate exactly what you're talking about, the space at Prescott.
It's not just Prescott. There are other small schools, Dr. Kieran. And like Franny said, it is about the kids. Now you're going to take kids that have been in these buildings.
Kids are our number one priority.
And we're just going to ship them and put them on buses now. And
we're going to shorten a lot of bus trips for many, many students.
In addition to that, the
cost. Fran
mentioned the cost. When I read the plan, it talked about classroom coaches. Where are they going to come from? Who's going to pay them? Itinerant supervisors?
We have outlined all of that for the board. They have everything in front of them.
Who are the supervisors? How much will they be paid? Have we thought about the cost of the plan and the logistics of this plan?
We have.
What is it? Take a loan.
As soon as we we can get board approval, we're going to immediately begin working on implementation. Yes, we are.
Hi, my name is Amy Beebe. I'm a second grade teacher at Whittier, and I didn't prepare anything, but I also have a few questions. First of all, you're voting on this tonight then? For sure?
Yes. Yeah, we'll be voting.
Okay, I did attend some of the other meetings, and I don't feel like it was discussed at all in public or in depth. So I know the discussion happened, you know, in committee behind closed doors. And I guess another question I have is, did you have Ms. Bond, do they have the correct number of people on the committees? So how could you vote on something without having the proper representation?
I believe we had more than the correct number on the committee.
Right. But the committee had 30 people.
They don't even know.
Yeah, you don't have to have a quorum. You come to consensus on what the plan, the committee agrees, and many people voted for it. So we heard from a person who did not. And I will be happy to have Ms. Cartagena do a thorough review of the entire plan for anyone who is interested in actually
before you vote, right?
I would like, see, that's my concern, is even a meeting that I was present at, Mrs. Cartagena actually, in my opinion, skirted around a few of the questions. Yes. She did not answer them.
We'll get you specific answers. I think it would be a good idea for all of those who are interested to be a part of it.
I also feel like you're doing that right now.
I'm not prepared to do a presentation to you.
I'm prepared to ask several of the directors to very specific questions then about the plan.
Well, this isn't a question-answer period.
Because we probably couldn't answer the questions. Yes.
I have a deep respect and regard for all of you. We are trying to do something to improve in this district, and I hope we can keep it at the level that we would like it to be, where we work together and not bring it down to them against us and go back to those.
I agree.
We don't need to go there.
Well, I would like to finish by saying that I don't want to go to that level either, but I feel like all of these meetings are the same. Yes. We don't really, I'm just being honest, we don't come away with clear answers. I feel like we're voting on things again before we clearly understand them. Yeah. And finally, you do have a showing here tonight, and you know, unfortunately, maybe they weren't at all the other meetings to have a deeper understanding.
I didn't get the phone call that you all received. Had I gotten the phone call from Ms. Boland asking for a presentation tonight, I guarantee you
I would like a public presentation to parents.
And we shall.
And then it should be voted on afterwards. I have one more question that is actually specifically about the layers. Can you tell me, Ms. Oleski, the layers, is that going to be the SPBH layer perhaps that we're all going to be receiving?
Well, I'm going to have Dr. Tyrion.
But that's my point, is that you just sat here and said you are all, you know what you're voting on. I'm not picking on you. I don't know you. Mr. Sheridan, is it going to be the SPBH, OCBBH, whatever we're saying these days? Is it going to be that layer that's going to be added?
That's one layer.
Are all of the students going to have access to the SPBH layer, or is it going to be the few that sign up? Mr. Timlin, is it SPBH, do you think, for everybody?
This is rude and uncalled
for. It is. Thank you.
He opened it.
Good evening, board members. My name is Carl Migatz. I'm here to speak on my son, Colin Migatz's behalf. A couple questions first. On your little committee or board that came up with this plan, how many specialists in autism were on that plan? Like doctors from Geisinger Bucknell Center for Autism. How many were on it?
I don't think any.
How many mental health behavioral specialists were on it? Not from Scranton Counseling Center, because don't even go there. How many were on this board? This committee that came up with this plan, how many? Because I'll tell you a little story about my son. He started off in Nichols Plaza this year, he started off fine. For whatever reason, in his head, open floor concept, no walls in the building, I don't know why, something triggered his autism. He started having behaviors. SBBH could not deal with him. They were not properly trained to deal with him. Your principal could not deal with him. No training to deal with him. Countless hours talked with doctors from Geisinger, Sarah Bucknell, different specialists, everything else, Ms. Cartegna. Everybody working as a team. His last IEP, there was like 22 people in the room. Family enrichment, everything. It was decided to move him over to Tripp Elementary School with approximately maybe 30 days left of the school year. First 4 days were horrible. After that, things got really good. He actually came home with an art project. First time, because at Nichols Plaza, he was basically locked in a room 3/4 of the school year. Enough that I hired an advocate and talked with an attorney. And you guys are going to be facing a lawsuit. And now you're telling me you want to move him from somewhere that he just became comfortable back to another school. What's going to happen? I can't predict it. Am I going to have to go get my advocate, my lawyer again? You're going to be facing a lawsuit. And you're telling me this board was made up of no certified doctors in autism, behavioral health, anything? A committee of teachers? That's not right. And then you're going to have these teachers shuffle around. They're not adequately trained to deal with these kids. I've been in the school. I've seen these kids go off on teachers. I've been there to give fire safety presentations, see these kids. I deal with them every day. I work for the city and the fire department. I see these kids every day. They're very difficult to deal with. You don't know day to day what's going to trigger them. But you're telling me you made up a committee with no specialists. I'd be really careful how I vote on this. Really careful.
Excuse me. My name is Donnell Terry and I work for Monticello. I'm an aide for an autistic student. Now to take my student out and put her back in her home school, you destroy her. And you move my teachers, you destroy them. You move any other than all these teachers, you would destroy their students. You move any student and put them in their home schools, you will destroy them. Because they've come a long way. All students. Because Monticello and all the other schools, all the 16 other school districts, their kids. Just like the firefighter said. Now you're going to take his son from Isaac and put him back in Nichols. It's going to destroy this kid. I know how it works. I work with an autistic student. She was here at Scranton High. She lasted 1 year. Now she's over at Monticello. She's wonderful. And the team over there is great. All these teachers are great. And you're going to switch around these teachers and give them other class kids? You're going to ruin kids. You really are. You're going to ruin the students of the Scranton School District.
That's I disagree.
No, I think you're wrong. You that's are going to ruin that's these fine. Students.
You can think I'm wrong.
Well, you come.
I have a lot of faith.
And you work one day with an autistic student. You work with an emotional student. One by one, I want you to see. You work, Ms. Carrion, Dr. Carrion. You work with an autistic student. You work with an emotional student. You work with a life skill student. Instead of sitting in your office, you come and work. What we do every day.
I've been there, done that.
I don't think so. Come and see what all these people do.
I appreciate and know what all these people do. I believe they have a calling, and I respect them
and I really resent
you standing there telling me that I'm going to ruin children when I am a child advocate and I'm looking
for... But everybody here knows that.
I know that.
They know that.
I'm not going to argue with you. I am not going to argue here with you.
All people are here for the children.
I would be happy to sit privately and hear all your concerns.
I'm here because of the children.
I'm here because of the children.
And you want to move these children out of their school where they're at and put them in their home school, like this firefighter's kid. He's done wonderful in Isaac, and now you're going to put him back in Nichols and ruin him? You're going to put my student back in Scranton High and ruin her? What? So, I think you all should think about it before you do it.
I don't get to vote, by the way.
Okay. Approve the minutes.
I'd like to make a motion to approve the meeting minutes from June 7th, 2016.
Second. Here in a second on the question. Question, roll call.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Duffy?
Yes.
Mr. Lesh?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mrs. Oleski?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
Nine of
them. Athletics to the stadium, Mr. Casey?
I have nothing yet this time.
Budget and finances? Director Lesh?
Yes. Two items here. To members of the Board of Directors of the School District of the City of Scranton, it is a recommendation to the Budget and Finance Committee that the following resolution be considered. A list of bill payments in accordance with the bill payment approval policy be approved as per attached. I so move. The orders be drawn upon the Treasury as follows. June 27, 2016, $1,161,530.82. I so move. Second.
Here's a second on the question. No question. Roll call.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Duffy?
Yes.
Mr. Lesh?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mrs. Oleski?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
Nine affirmative.
10B2, to the members of the Board of Directors of the School District of the City of Scranton. It is the recommendation of the Budget and Finance Committee that the following resolution be considered. The exception bill list as per bill payment approval policy for the period ending June 27, 2016 be approved as per attached. I so move. Second.
Here in a second. Another question? No question. Roll call.
Mr. Duffy?
Yes.
Mr. Lesh?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mrs. Oleski?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
Nine affirmative.
Is that all?
No, there's more. 10B3, to the members of the Board of School Directors of the City of Scranton, the Budget and Finance Committee presents the following resolution for your consideration. Be it resolved that the delinquent tax reports for April 2016 and May 2016 be accepted below. A copy of the monthly detail is available for review in the business office. As per attached, I so move. Second.
Here in a second. Another question? No question. Roll call.
Mr. Lesh?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mrs. Oleski?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwight?
Yes.
Mr. Duffy?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
Nine affirmative.
So the members of the board, B4. The members of the Board of School Directors of the City of Scranton, the Budget and Finance Committee presents the following resolution for your consideration. Be resolved that the Treasurer's Report ending February 2016, March 2016, and April 2016 be accepted as follows, per attached.
Second.
Second.
Here another question? No question, roll call.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mrs. Olesky?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Duffy?
Yes.
Mr. Lesh?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
Tonight affirmative.
Is there a reason as to why there's no non-consent agenda anymore? Did I miss the memo?
Yes.
Did we discuss this?
Yes.
When?
Last meeting.
Where there was confusion over things that were in the consent agenda that shouldn't have been there?
2 months ago?
About 6 weeks.
6 weeks. Okay.
I do have a question for a solicitor. On B5, do I need to spell out the names? Or?
No.
No? It just says per attached?
Per attached. That's per attached.
To the members of the Board of Directors, it is the recommendation of the Budget and Finance Committee that the following resolution be approved. Whereas in accordance with the real estate tax law, any property not sold at judicial sale shall be listed as a repository of unsold properties to be placed for bid, and if sold, will return to tax-paying status with the Tax Claim Bureau. The following properties have been sold and will net the district $12,654.14 as per attached. Therefore, be resolved that the Scranton District, or the School District of the City of Scranton, does hereby approve the above referenced properties for repository sale, pursuant to the real estate tax law in Section 627 of said Act. This resolution is subject to the approval of other taxing bodies. I so move.
Second.
Here in a second. Another question? Here no question. Roll call.
Mrs. Olesky?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwight?
Yes.
Mr. Duffy?
Yes.
Mr. Lesh?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
Nine affirmative.
B6. Members of the Board of Directors of the School District of the City of Scranton. It is a recommendation of the Budget and Finance Committee that the following be approved. Be it resolved that the Chief Financial Officer, Greg L. Sunday, is hereby authorized to approve payments of all payables during summer months in the absence of regular scheduled board meetings. Be it further resolved that with the scheduling of the regular board meeting, all summer payments will be accepted by the Board of Directors at the regular September board meeting. I so move.
Second. Here in a second. Another question? No question. Roll call.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Duffy?
Yes.
Mr. Lesh?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mrs. Olesky?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
Nine affirmative.
B7. To the members of the Board of School Directors of the City of Scranton. The Budget and Finance Committee presents the following resolution for your consideration. Whereas the Land Bank, County Municipality, and the School District have all joined to create stronger communities in dealing with vacant, abandoned, and tax delinquent properties, maintaining them and attempting to restore them to productive use. And whereas the County Municipality and the School District wish to encourage Land Bank to acquire vacant, abandoned, blighted, and tax delinquent properties, and based upon the mutual agreements hereon contained for good and valuable consideration, the Scranton School Board hereby agrees to intergovernment cooperation agreement and a memorandum of understanding as per attached. I so move.
Second.
Here is second. Another question?
I have a question. We discussed this previous to this, that we were going to try to get some representation on this board. Has that occurred? Or have we spoken to someone about having one of the board members represent the board?
I sat on the one meeting with the library committee when this was started, but I do remember saying that we wanted to have somebody. I think the county agreed to have one of our directors on there.
Yeah, two members on an advisory
committee. Anything else on the question?
Yes. Oh, nothing on the question, sir.
Nothing on the question, Mr. Lesh. Roll call.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwight?
Yes.
Mr. Duffy?
Yes.
Mr. Lesh?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mrs. Olesky?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
Nine affirmative.
B8, to the members of the board. Board of School Directors of the City of Scranton. The Budget and Finance Committee presents the following resolution for your consideration. Be resolved that the Scranton School District authorizes the new home construction local tax abatement and new business construction local tax abatement program for a two-year period from the date of occupancy. Pursuant to the attached ordinance of the City of Scranton, upon adoption of this resolution, the program will remain in effect for a two-year period, with a two-year tax abatement being granted as a maximum exemption, and in effect for a 10-year period pursuant to the attached order of the City of Scranton. Be it further resolved that this program is contingent upon the approval of the City of Scranton and Lackawanna County approve the program as per attached. I so move.
Second. Here's a second. Another question. I'd like to say that this is a great thing. I hope that families and businessmen take advantage of this tax abatement and bring some new homes and new businesses in the City of Scranton. God knows we need them. And I think it's a good thing to move forward. Roll call.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Duffy?
Yes.
Mr. Lush?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mr. Soleski?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
And affirmative.
Anything else under?
Nothing else, sir.
Technology, Director Soleski.
Thank you. To the members of the Board of School Directors of the City of Scranton, it is the recommendation of the Superintendent and Technology Committee to upgrade the phone system in the administration building, and the Board of School Directors hereby authorize the Technology Department to research various options. Respectfully submitted.
Second. Here in a second, under roll call. I have another question. Roll call.
Research various options. Does that just mean bid?
No, it just means research.
Okay.
That means our network upgrade. We think there'll be an opportunity for substantial savings, not just in the administration building, but across the district, as far as running our whole phone system across our data network. We're going to look at that, and we're going to seek proposals. And that's all I'm asking for, is the ability to go out and do that.
Thank you.
I have something on the question. I know it's somewhat related. An update on the PA system.
Okay, thank you. All of the phone material was delivered to the building. The antenna and everything has been mounted.
Thank
you. Roll call.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Duffy?
Yes.
Mr. Lush?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mrs. Soleski?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
And affirmative.
Education, Director Dwyer.
Resolution 10D1. Members of the Board of the School Directors of the City of Scranton. The Education Committee requests board approval of staff attendance to conferences and meetings for professional development relevant to their specific duties and responsibilities as per attached. Respectfully submitted.
Second. Here's a second. Another question? No question? Roll call.
Mr. Duffy?
Yes.
Mr. Lush?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mrs. Soleski?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
And affirmative.
Resolution 10D2, to the members of the Board of School Directors of the City of Scranton, it is the recommendation of the Education Committee that the following resolution be approved. Be it resolved that the Scranton School Board of Directors hereby designates Robert Casey as a representative to NEIU 19, beginning July 1, 2016, effective through June 30, 2017, respectively submitted.
Second. Okay, another question? No question. Roll call.
Mr. Lush?
Yes.
Mr. McKinnon?
Yes.
Mrs. Soleski?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Duffy?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
And affirmative.
Resolution 10D3. The members of the Board of School Directors of the City of Scranton, is the recommendation of the Superintendent and Education Committee that the attached child study referral process is approved. Respectfully submitted.
Second. Here in a second. Another question? No question? Roll call.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mrs. Olesky?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwyhee?
Yes.
Mr. Duffy?
Yes.
Mr. Lesh?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
Nine affirmative.
Resolution D4, to the members of the Board of School Directors of the City of Scranton, it is the recommendation of the Superintendent and the Education Committee that the attached induction plan for newly certified teachers is approved. Respectfully submitted.
Second.
And a second. Another question?
I have a question.
I have a comment. Go ahead, Mr. Schuster.
Well, my question was, there's a stipend in here for the mentored teachers to receive. What is that stipend?
It's called, that is the daily rate on that.
It's actually on page.
It's a yearly stipend. It's $1,000. Thank you.
Thank you.
And my comment was to thank Ms. Boland and her staff. This is part of the Pennsylvania Department of Education strategic plan. She and her staff took full responsibility. Since that falls in their purview, to put a great plan together. Thank you all.
Likewise, congratulations, Louise.
Yes, thank you. Ms. Louise?
Yes. Respectfully submitted.
Here in a second. Another question? No question. Roll call.
Mrs. Olesky?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwyhee?
Yes.
Mr. Duffy?
Yes.
Mr. Lesh?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
Nine affirmative.
Is that all, Mr. Dwight?
One more. 10G1. It is the recommendation that the superintendent and the intergovernmental committee that the following is approved. Whereas due to the dire financial situation that the school districts in the state of Pennsylvania are facing and the uncertainty of the adoption of a state budget, the Scranton School Board of Directors urges legislators to address the needs of school districts in Pennsylvania and hereby approve the legislative priorities as attached.
Here in a second, on the question.
I have something quickly on the question. With all the stuff that we're talking about and how important everything is, when it comes to a financial aspect, there's nothing that's more important than some kind of legislative change on the state level. It's starting to take place with the fair funding formula, but education has been severely depleted, and we're only starting to make minuscule gains. If this doesn't happen and we just read this off and it falls on deaf ears, we're really going to be spinning our wheels for the next decades to come trying to fill some of the gap that's been shortened in the past 4 or 5 years. So I hope this doesn't fall on deaf ears, and I hope that people take heed of this warning, because this is the most important financial document that's in this packet tonight.
Thank you, Mr.
Just to clarify the agenda, do we move down to education that was intergovernmental?
Correct.
Roll call.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwight?
Yes.
Mr. Duffy?
Yes.
Mr. Lesh?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mrs. Olesky?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
Nine affirmative.
Labor Relations Director Schuster.
Thank you. To the board members of the Board of School Directors of the City of Scranton, the Labor Relations Committee presents the following resolution for your consideration. It is a recommendation of the Labor Relations Committee that the following is approved. Whereas the Scranton Federation of Teachers filed a grievance G-1316, and where the grievance was heard by the Labor Relations Committee and both sides had their opportunity to present evidence and make arguments on the issues presented, therefore, after deliberating on the same as it relates to the grievance EG, the grievance is hereby denied. Respectfully submitted.
Second.
Here in a second. On the question.
On the question, clarification, a vote of yes is a vote for denial.
Yes.
Thank you.
Roll call.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Duffy?
Yes.
Mr. Lush?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mrs. Zaleski?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
No.
Eight affirmative, one negative, motion passes.
To the members of the Board of School Directors of the City of Scranton, the Labor Relations Committee presents the following resolution for your consideration. It is recommended by the Labor Relations Committee that the following is approved. Whereas the Scranton Federation of Teachers filed a grievance G-1416, where the grievance was heard by the Labor Relations Committee and both sides had the opportunity to present evidence and to make arguments on the issues presented. Therefore, after deliberating on the same as it relates to the grievance is hereby denied. Respectfully submitted.
Second.
Hearing a second. Under question? Question, roll call.
Mr. Casey?
No.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Duffy?
No.
Mr. Lush?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
No.
Mrs. Zaleski?
No.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
No.
Mr. Sheridan?
No.
Six negative, three affirmative, motion failed.
Policy and legislation. Mr. Timlin?
It is the recommendation of the superintendent and the policy committee to adopt the administering of naloxone policy as per the attached. And naloxone is Narcan and respectfully submitted.
Second. Second.
Hearing a second on your question. No question, roll call.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Duffy?
Yes.
Mr. Lush?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mrs. Zaleski?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
Nine affirmative.
It is the recommendation of the superintendent and the policy committee to adopt the assignment within district boundaries exceptions policy as per the attached. Respectfully submitted.
Second.
Second.
Hearing a second. Under the question. Hear no question. Roll call.
Mr. Duffy?
Yes.
Mr. Lush?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mrs. Zaleski?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
Nine affirmative.
It is the recommendation of the superintendent and the legislative and federal programs committee that the following is approved. Be it resolved that permission is granted for the Scranton School District to submit the following grant applications for the 2016-2017 school year. Respectfully submitted.
Second.
Hearing a second. Under question?
No.
Under question? Roll call.
Mr. Lush?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mrs. Zaleski?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Duffy?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
Nine affirmative.
Personnel, Director Duffy.
To the members of the Board of School Directors of the City of Scranton, it is the recommendation of the Personnel Committee that the attached list of appointments, assignments, resignations, leaves of absence, and professional contracts is approved. Respectfully submitted.
Hearing a second. Another question? Roll call.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mrs. Zaleski?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Duffy?
Yes.
Mr. Lush?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
Moving on, J2. Members of the Board of School Directors of the City of Scranton, the Personnel Committee presents the following resolution for your consideration. Be resolved that the Scranton School Board agrees to adopt the amended Scranton School District Organizational Chart as per attached. Respectfully submitted.
Second.
Hearing a second. Any question? Roll call.
Mrs. Zaleski?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwyer?
No.
Mr. Duffy?
Yes.
Mr. Lush?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
Eight affirmative, one negative, motion passed.
Moving down to Buildings and Grounds, Mr. Lush.
M1, members of the Board of School Directors of the City of Scranton. The Building and Grounds Committee presents the following resolution for your consideration. Be resolved that the Buildings and Grounds Committee requests permission to authorize Commonwealth Energy to solicit natural gas and electric bids on behalf of the Scranton School District. I so move.
Second. Here's a second. Another question? Roll call.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Duffy?
Yes.
Mr. Lush?
Yes.
Mr. McCander?
Yes.
Mrs. Olesky?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
Tonight affirmative.
M2, to the members of the Board of School Directors of the City of Scranton. The Buildings and Grounds Committee presents the following resolution for your consideration. Be it resolved that the lowest responsible bid proposal for floor tile repair and ceiling patching and painting in the toilet rooms at McNichols Plaza Elementary School be awarded as follows. Sean Bryan Construction, $9,900. I so move.
Second. Here's a second. Another question? Roll call.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Duffy?
Yes.
Mr. Lush?
Yes.
Mr. McCander?
Yes.
Mrs. Olesky?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
I have one.
Anything else on the building grounds?
Yes, one more. M3, the members of the Board of School Directors of the City of Scranton. The Buildings and Grounds Committee presents the following resolution for your consideration. Be it resolved that the lowest responsible bid proposal for West Scranton High School steps and malicious repairs, or miscellaneous repairs, project be awarded to Artistic. Base bid $176,738. Base bid $128,760. Base bid $373,908. Be it further resolved, it is the recommendation that base bid three of $173,908 is approved. I so move.
Here's a second.
Second.
Here's a second. Another question?
Can we just have a little discussion about how the 173,908 was arrived at?
Originally, when this project came out, we looked at the front entrance to Westside High School with the sidewalks and the pads. So we addressed that and the pillars. In addition, during the process, the side parking lot on the 13th Avenue side, which has turned up pretty much dirt. I think we had two people fall there. We added that as a paving project. We also added two rear entrances, which are slate, which have sunken probably 2 inches in spots, but the grout has stayed up, so we're trying to secure those. In addition to the same bid, while they're going to be bidding on the paving for that, we did have them look at and bid on the far end of the stadium, which is all mud. If any of you go down there, people are having a hard time walking around if there's any kind of rain. It's not where the practice football field is. So it's just an addition of all those that were added to the project. Okay, and I believe there were, I'm going to say, at least 8-9 bid packages picked up, and at least 7 responded to the advertised bid.
Okay, thank you. Anyone else under the question? Roll call.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwight?
Yes.
Mr. Duffy?
Yes.
Mr. Lush?
Yes.
Mr. McCander?
Yes.
Mrs. Olesky?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
Night affirmative.
Special Education, Director Olesky.
Yes, thank you. N1. To the members of the Board of Directors, Special Education Committee hereby recommends the following resolution for your consideration. Whereas the school district in the city of Scranton is subject to administration proceedings and civil suits, wherein the appropriateness of a student's special education program has been challenged, or suits have been filed in these matters. KH2016, KYH2016, JC2016, JF2016, GM2016, LCM2016, JR2016, and AG2016. And whereas the parties have reached a settlement agreement in this matter upon the terms and conditions previously provided for your consideration, and therefore be it resolved
that the settlements as indicated above be approved upon the terms and conditions as described, and the Superintendent of Directors in Special Education hereby authorizes to execute any and all documents necessary to consummate this matter. Respectfully submitted.
Second.
Here in a second. Under question. One question, roll call.
Mr. Dwight?
Yes.
Mr. Duffy?
Yes.
Mr. Lesh?
Yes.
Mr. McCander?
Yes.
Mrs. Olesky?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
In affirmative.
And two, to the members of the Board of Directors and School Directors of the City of Scranton, is the recommendation of the Superintendent that the following resolution be approved. Whereas a task force comprised of teachers, administrators, convened and studied the current Scranton School District special education delivery model, and whereas the task force determined a need for improvement in the current model, and whereas the special education task force envisioned a change in what would better serve the students of the Scranton School District, therefore be resolved that the School Board of Directors accepts the recommendation and the service delivery model as presented. Respectfully submitted.
Second.
Here in a second. Another question?
On the question, I'd like to make a move to divide this question or divide the resolution so as to consider separately the school year of 2016-17 or 2017-2018.
Second. So, Mr. Schuster, what's your recommendation and what?
Well, in this way, we can make the 10 moves that we're suggesting in 2016 and then revisit this for 2017.
So, more or less, a one
year. When it comes to the plan analysis, the cost analysis. Yes.
One year visit, then, right?
Yes. Yes.
We're going to phase it in over a 2 year period.
Phase it in over a 2 year period.
Yeah, but we want to vote on just 1 year. First of all, we know it can be financed for a year. Secondly, we'd like to see if this plan's working for us and for these people out here.
Makes sense.
We'd make any corrections.
Makes sense.
I'd like to see myself under a 1 year term because at the end of the year,
if it's working,
yeah. We're still in the question. If it's working, then we can look at it. If it's not working, again, we can look at it better too.
And again, from a cost perspective, the first year is more cost neutral, whereas the other 2 years are.
Yeah, there's a question mark in the second year.
Yes, it's too many assumptions.
Right. Everybody agree? Okay.
Roll call on that motion.
We'll make a roll call on that motion. We have a second, first of all.
Yes, we did.
Okay, we have a second on the question. None? No more? Okay, roll call.
Mr. Duffy?
Yes.
Mr. Lesh?
Yes.
Mr. McCander?
Yes.
Mrs. Olesky?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwight?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
Nine affirmative.
That's all I had.
No, now we have to vote.
Okay.
We're not the motion. Now we have to vote on the 1 year old plan.
We have a second on the motion.
And this would be for the first year.
Other questions? No other question? Roll call.
Mr. Lesh?
Yes.
Mr. McCander?
Yes.
Mrs. Olesky?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Just to confirm, this would be on the first year. Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwight?
Yes.
Mr. Duffy?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin? Mr. Sheridan, I'm sorry. Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
Nine affirmative.
That's all. Thank you.
Okay, we're
going to
go down to business.
Oh,
no. Vocational education.
The Vocational Education Committee presents the following motion for your consideration. Be it resolved that the budget of the Career Technology Center of Lackawanna County for the fiscal year of July 1, 2016 to June 30, 2017 be approved as previously presented for your consideration. Respectfully submitted.
Second.
Here's a second. Another question? Roll call.
Mr. McCandrew?
I have to recuse myself as I.
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Tinlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Dunn?
Yes.
Mr. Lush?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
Eight affirmative, one abstention, motion carries.
It is the recommendation of the superintendent that the following resolution be approved. Whereas the participating Scranton School District sophomore students need an adequate amount of time for studies at the Career Technology Center, referred as a CTC, and whereas sophomore students currently spend only 2 hours of their school day at the CTC, and whereas shifting the time of the instructional period for physical education, health and safety courses would allow for an additional instructional period at CTC. Therefore, be it resolved, the Scranton School Board of Directors accept the proposed Career Technology Center schedule adjustment, respectfully submitted.
Second.
Here in a second. Any question? Roll call.
Mrs. Olesky?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Tinlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Duffy?
Yes.
Mr. Lush?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
Nine affirmative.
We're down on their new business. Discussion.
You know what, I'm going to make a suggestion that with regard to the new facility on Dixon Avenue, that the programs contained therein maintain their names. That the Monticello program, that the Lincoln Jackson Academy program, maintain their identities at whatever we want to call the Dixon Avenue facility. I think it's less confusing. I think we won't have to re-educate people as to what is now not Monticello anymore. And I think we just serve the programs better if we keep their names and we find a suitable name for the Dixon Avenue facility. That's one guy's opinion.
That was the intent of what we gave to you, the suggestions for names submitted by the two schools for the overall facility, and the two programs within would remain Monticello and Lincoln Jackson.
For consideration.
Okay, I mean, we're not going to vote on this tonight, right?
No.
For discussion, right? So we can talk over our next work session. Okay. Under the President's report, I would just like to thank everyone in our school district, from our teachers, to our aides, to our maintenance, to everyone that works in the Scranton School District. Thank you for a great year. It's been a great opportunity to work with you in the last year, even though all of us, we all went through a tough task in the last year, from a strike in the beginning to a budget deficit and almost a default in December. There were this board, and I want to thank the board for working very hard with all of us, and the teachers' union, and everybody involved in this school district that made everything come together, made our district stay. We're looking at closing our schools January 1st because of possible default. It didn't happen because everybody in this room, everybody in this district worked together to make that not happen. I'm proud of that, and I'm proud of every worker in this district for keep making that. Sometimes we agree, sometimes we don't agree, but at the end, it's the best for the education of our children. And I want to thank everybody, because we are recessing for the summer, the board, and I just want to take this opportunity to say thank you on behalf of our board. And have a good summer, be a safe summer. Thank you. I'll enter, make it into German.
Second.
You're in a second. German.